那Helen, would you please?
请各位用热情掌声欢迎我们今天来宾 Helen Fontaine， 女士，分享她今天的主题，欢迎回家 ，Welcome home。
Well, welcome, yes. I'm going to be translated. My apologies. I don't speak Mandarin that well, but I have somebody who is able to help me out. Today, I'm going to tell you something about our Colour Future Strand work that we do every year. And I'm going to explain everything about why we do it, how we do it, and what we, in the end, came to find out.
大家午安，今天我要和大家来谈谈我们的年度色彩趋势的发表。在接下来的发表会，大家可以进一步了解这些色彩趋势的细节。
So, I work for AkzoNobel. AkzoNobel is the mother company of Dulux, and we sell paint. We don't just sell paint, we actually sell a beautiful product that you can use in interior and exterior environments.
大家好，我在阿克苏诺贝尔公司工作。那阿克苏诺贝尔是德利的母公司。那我们主要的产品除了就是一般见的涂料以外呢，还有各式各样可以运用在居家设计的许多许多商品、许多产品，我们都有涵盖。
As said, our Colour Futures trend research is something we do every year, and we do that because we want to know what our consumers are going to like, colour-wise, before they even know it themselves.
那每年呢，我们都会走在消费者的前面，甚至在消费者还不知道、还在摸索的时候，我们就可以早他们一步预测出他们会喜欢什么颜色。
First, let me tell you something about me. I think I was introduced in a thorough way, but I'm the head of the Global Aesthetic Center, or the creative director of the Global Aesthetic Center of AkzoNobel, working for Dulux, and my team designs the color palettes and the color concepts, and we do color trend forecast research.
那刚才主持人已经把我的背景，相信他已经介绍非常清楚了，所以我就很快的稍微讲一下我的背景。我是在荷兰的阿姆斯特丹阿克苏诺贝尔美学中心工作。那我们的工作呢，就是为我们旗下的品牌，包含Dulux 还有其他的品牌，设计出色彩相关的一些设计。那我们也会每年会推出就是色组让大家参考。
We do our trend research to be, as I said, to be able to provide our customers and consumers with the right colors when it comes to paint. And we have been doing this for 15 years now. And I'm quite proud to say that in these 15 years, we were able to predict or to forecast the colors that were going to be popular in a very nice way.
那就像我刚刚所说的，我们的工作主要内容呢，就是为各位消费者预测，规划出就是这个时代流行的颜色。那我们做这样的事情已经长达15年的时间。那我也可以很骄傲的说，我们做的相当不错。我们用这个呈现的方式呢，消费者都能接受，而且大家都会觉得这是一个很好的呈现方式。
We of course do our trend forecast research, not only because of the stories, we want to really understand our consumers so that we can translate the color trends we're talking about into our analysis work, because we have to analyze the colors to be able to produce beautiful fendex, color flows, etc.
那就我刚刚所说的，就是我们预测还有发表的方式呢，不只是会借由就是一些比较动人的故事，其实我们会用比较有系统的分析方式来很精准的，就是预测，然后规划出这些色组。那我们也会发行色卡，让消费者可以比较有具体的了解。
And I can tell you a lot about what you can see here on screen, but the most important thing is that you probably notice sometimes.Well, for example, the blues are more important, where in other cases, in other years, the yellows are more important.
那可以在投影片上面看到，就是我们历年的一些色组的一个趋势。有些年度呢，你会发现，蓝色的比重好像比较重。那在有些年度呢，黄色是比较受到欢迎。
And that's something we have to incorporate in our trend palettes and in our normal color work, of course, working for all those countries.
所以我们在就是我们的美学设计中心，然后还有其他所有的品牌呢，我们都会有这样的一个讨论，然后发表就是该年度的色组或是色卡。
And once a year, we nominate one color to be the most important color, and that color represents the mood of the moment, and that is our color of the year.
那每个年度呢，我们都会选一个年度颜色、年度代表色来诠释那个时代当下大家的一个氛围或是心情，那我们会把它称之为年度颜色。
So, we do our trend research 365 days a year with my team at the Global Aesthetic Center. But once a year, we try to, well, we want to have a discussion with people that are not working within Akzo Nobel. So we invite a group of international designers representing all parts of the world.
那我们的这个中心呢，算是日以继夜，就是非常努力的研究。但是呢，我们不只是 Akzo Nobel 自己内部在讲而已，我们其实每年都会邀请许多外部的专家，也许是不同产业的专家一起进行讨论，一起参与。那这样可以有比较全面的一个讨论。
So, as I said, they represent all areas of design, and we have these interesting conversations with them. This is where they all come from, and there's an architect, there's somebody working in textile design for projects, there's somebody working doing color of trend forecast as their profession. A varied group of people with which we have interesting discussions.
那就像我刚刚所讲到的，我们邀请的外部专家呢，他们可能是来自各行各业不同的领域。那除了就是本行以外，我们也会邀请，比如说建筑师，比如说还有纺织业的、织品业的一些专家一起来讨论，这样我们就可以涵盖很全面的一个会的彼此之间的对话，可以很全面的。
So we have very interesting discussions, and definitely not only about color. We talk about economic trends, we talk about social and societal trends. Of course, we add our knowledge when it comes to design, and we talk a bit about color.
当然在这个讨论里面呢，我们会讲不止颜色的东西，其实我们涵盖甚至连经济怎么样啊，社会怎么样等等一些更大范围的议题也会涵盖讨论。当然我们也会谈论设计，因为这是我们的本行。那在谈论设计的时候，我们就会把我们的专业给加进去。
Because when we really start talking about color is when I take this information after a 3-day brainstorm with me to my colleagues of Akzo Nobel, those color experts, then we start translating the trends into color palettes.
那这个讨论呢会持续整整三天哦。那我们会和同事有一个非常全面的讨论，我们才会就是把范围继续缩小到这个色彩，才会界定出就是该年度的色彩。
And I ask these color experts to tell me what they think is going to be the color of next year.
我就会邀请这些色彩专家告诉我，跟我分享他们觉得就是接下来的年度会流行怎么样的色彩趋势。
So just to share with you, what did we talk about in this brainstorm with those designers?
那我接下来就跟大家分享我和这些设计师所谈论的关于色彩的趋势，我们谈论到什么东西呢？
So we talked about politics and how unpredictable our world is at the moment when it comes to politics.
我们谈论到最近的政治啊，相当的动荡，就是我们的政治氛围似乎是传达出一种不安的感觉。
And we talked about robotics and technique, and we just all wondered if we would have jobs in 20 years' time, or whether we're going to have a lot of free time on our hands.
我们也谈论了科技，还有现在流行谈论机器人相关的人工智慧。那我们就有些人会担心，过二十年会不会大家都失业了，被机器人取代？那也许另外一个方面，会有人觉得，搞不好我们二十年后会很闲，就是因为机器人取代我们的工作。
We also talked about the fact that we store all our knowledge and all our data in those big clouds, and who is keeping guard on all our data? I mean, who is responsible to really make sure that it stays ours?
那我们也谈论关于云端，我们现在大家都知道把数据资料都放上云端去了，那我们也不免担心说，哎，那谁会来担任我们这些各自的守门人？我们的各自是不是真的能够还保护得很好呢？
But we also talked about the 24/7 economy that we have to be always on. And we talked about the importance of sleep and rest.
那现在大家都是24小时全年无休的在工作，我们的经济啊驱使我们不断努力工作，所以我们也常常会谈论到睡眠与休息的重要。
And we also talked about the new interpretation of the Maslow pyramid, where we can see that Wi-Fi andElectricity are almost the most important things in our lives these days.
那大家可能对于马洛斯的金字塔还蛮熟悉的。那很有趣的是，我们现在看到位于金字塔底端的，居然已经不是一些生理需求，而是Wi-Fi， 还有就是你的电池有没有电，变成大家最关心的一件事情。
So, and we talked about the changing meaning of words, where we can say that things become ideas, or teaching becomes learning, or stability becomes resilience. Changing of the idea of the meaning of words.
那我们也发现有些字义的诠释也出现了变化，就是以前流行可能比如说是重视教导，然后或是一些采取行动等等，可是现在大家会把重心转往要如何好好的学习，怎么样就是看到这些字就是经营人际关系等等，所以大家每个年代在谈论的字眼或是每个字代表意义都会随着时代有不同的诠释。
Since we're living in changing times, but we also talked about hope, because as Leonard Cohen used to sing, there's a crack in everything, and that's how the light gets in. There's light at the end of our tunnel.
那即使在这么动荡不安、充满不安的年代呢，我们还是会不放弃希望。这个时候，大家也常会谈论希望这个字哦，因为我这边分享一个quote， 一个格言，就是说不管在哪里总是会有裂缝让光透进来，我们永远都会有希望。
And we talked about designers and hope, and that there's a younger generation that just embraces these changes, and it's not as frightening as a lot of other people do think it is.
那这样年轻的世代的话，就会也许也是蛮多人抱持乐观的心情，他们会谈论关于希望，关于就是许多比较人性美好、生活美好的一面。
So all in all, we talked, as I said, we talked about the 24/7 economy, we talked about technology, the big data, the algorithms and how we're followed on social media. We talked about fake news and the information saturation.
所以在今年的这个年度讨论里面呢，这个投影片上面就是今年我们谈论一些主题和关键字。我们谈到全年不休无休的这个经济、科技、大数据、云端算术，还有假新闻，还有资讯爆炸，或是就是不断的新闻轰炸这些字。
Right, so the mood of the moment we said is one of unpredictability.
所以现在当下的一个氛围就是一个不安定、无法预测的感觉。
We don't exactly know what we're up for in the next coming years.
我们都不晓得接下来的一年会发生什么事情。
Right. So we, as a paint company, what do we do with this information? And we thought, how does this translate to our consumers and customers? How does it influence them and the way they live and the way they live in their houses?
身为涂料公司，我们要怎么样因应这个趋势呢？我们要怎么样把我们获得的讯息转换给我们的客户，还有我们的消费者，让他们在家中呈现呢？这是我们要讨论的。
And we said there's actually three ways of reacting to these times of insecurity. You can be very protective about your old way of living, and you can kind of keep everything outside.You can be really open about it and just think, oh, we have to live our lives anyway, so let's make the most of it. Or you can be open and very enthusiastic about what's happening at the moment and be flexible and explore.
那 我们归纳出就是因应这样子充满不安定的未来，我们可以有三种因应方式。你可以选择保护你自己，就是把外界一些纷纷扰扰就隔在外头。那你也可以选择你采取开放的态度，就是反正日子都是要过下去，那不如就好好的利用这个动荡不安带来的一些效果。那第三个是你可以去尽情的探索这个世界。有些人对于科技是保有热情的，所以他们是选择去探索这个世界。
So, but what all of these people need, and actually, I think what we all need, being here together.
那我们到底需要什么呢？就是面对这样子快节奏的变化。
Is as life gets more complicated, now is the time to choose to press pause. Our home can be our nest, where we can all find.
那我们答案是呢？日子既然过得越来越复杂，那现在该是按下暂停键的时候。如果我们把人生看作一个这个播放的话，我们把它按下暂停键，那我们的家就成为一个我们安心的窝，让我们在这个地方可以找到。
Okay, where we can all find a welcome home, or if you talk about commercial spaces, a welcome space to work or to leisure.
我们在这个地方可以找到一个令人安心舒适的家，那或者说你可以把这个概念应用在办公室的话，就是一个可以让你安心工作的地方或者一个空间。
So, as always, as in the last 15 years, we nominate a group of colors to be our color palette of the year.
那在过去15年呢，我们就是每年都会发布一个色组。
And this year it's 37 colors. We really think less is more. It makes it easier to choose from for our consumers. And one of these colors is the color of the year.
那这个色组今年呢会有36+1，就是我们有36种颜色为基底，然后再选出一个特别的代表年度色。那我们相信越简单越好，所以就是精选出这36+1的组合。
So, last year we had Denim Drift, and the year before we had Cherished Gold, and 2 years ago we had Copper Blush.
那在2015年的时候跟大家分享一下过去的历届年度颜色。2015年我们是有一个暖铜橙，然后2016年我们有一个金石年华，2017年我们有一个丹宁湛蓝。
And this year, I'm proud to present to you Heartwood to be our color of the year of 2018.
那今年度的颜色呢，我们称之为暖木棕 Heartwood 是选出来是代表年度的颜色。
Good. So how do we use this Heartwood color in our homes? Heartwood is a grown-up, sophisticated pink.As I always say, I'm very proud of this color because it's a versatile color that combines in a very, very nice way with a lot of other colors around it. We were inspired by the beautiful shades of warm wood you see being used at the moment, walnut, chestnut kind of woods. And it's an easy color, easy to use.
那我们要怎么样把这个暖木棕应用在我们的居家空间呢？就是首先这个颜色呢，它是一个比较粉色系、暖色系的感觉，它的很细致。那它算是一个很好搭的颜色哦，因为它透露出木头的温暖的感觉。那比如说核桃棕啊，或是这个胡桃木的这个颜色，就是像这个颜色延伸出来的方式。
We can use it in our homes or in commercial spaces, but we can also use it in architecture on the exterior of our houses.
那这个颜色呢，我们可以把它应用在居家，可以应用在办公室，也可以把它应用在建筑外观的颜色。
So, each year we have a color of the year palette because we know our consumers and customers are different. They have different color needs and different color preferences. So we design a color palette that complements and that gives the, well,an environment for our color of the year.
那我们知道其实每个消费者彼此之间还是会有些不一样，所以虽然我们定调出这个颜色的话，我们还是会因应不同的消费者不同的需求来讨论，就是这个颜色可以怎么样运用在不同的环境或者不同的应用。
So this is our Heartwood Home color palette. Our Heartwood Home color palette.
那这个接下来我们要呈现的就是我们今年暖木棕它延伸出来的色组。
These colors give a welcome home in your, in the environments that you design.
那这个软木棕的颜色呢，它就是可以应用在你的居家空间，呈现一种很舒适、很开放的这个感觉。
So, because when we shut the door on the outside world, we step into a place that is uniquely ours, where the people and things we love just fit, where we dream a little further and we breathe a little deeper.
那就是当我们回到这个很舒适的家的时候呢，我们把门关起来，就可以把外界的纷纷扰扰给隔绝在外面，因为觉得这个家是只属于我们的，那就是正适合我们还有我们爱的人一起待在这个很舒适的空间。那在这个空间呢，我们可以放心的做梦，然后也可以深呼吸放松。
As said, this color palette creates a welcome home.
所以这个就是一个很开放、很舒适的一个居家空间。
And now I'm going to show you a lot of slides where we applied these beautiful colors on the wall just to inspire you and to show you how we use these colors and how we combine them.
那所以接下来的投影片的一些照片呢，我就可以跟大家示范要怎么样把这个颜色用在墙壁上面的颜色，这个涂料的颜色，让大家有比较清楚的概念。
Because we believe seeing is believing, and one picture says more than 1,000 words.
因为我相信眼见为凭哦，图片可以比言语更清楚地说明我的概念。
Right, so small space living with our color of the year.
那所以这个呢，就是我们这个年度颜色可以设计出来的这个居家空间。
But also exterior, beautiful architecture with the color of the year.And how it's applied in the interior of this building.
那所以在照片里面可以看到，就是建筑的外观采用软木棕可以呈现怎么样的效果？那或是说来到建筑物的里头，这个内部的设计装潢也可以用软木棕呈现这样的效果。
But also a hotel bar and a commercial space.
那在商业空间，像这张照片所呈现的是一个饭店大厅的这个 bar。
And the hotel room that is on top of this hotel bar.
那在这个左边，对比右边的话，可以看到这个是饭店房间，也是可以采用软木棕的这个色系。
But also in a kitchen, and there here we combine it with this beautiful inspiration source wood.
那在这个是一个厨房，就是我们结合了这个木头色调。
And as you can see, well, we made a beautiful combination with blue, which is inspired by our.Last year's, or actually this year's color of the year, denim drift, which we still love, and we still see a big future for blue as well.
那这张照片里面可以看到，暖木棕也可以跟蓝色做结合。那我们刚讲就是大家记得吗？就是最近前一个年度的那个流行色是蓝色系，就是刚刚讲丹宁湛蓝。所以其实这个丹宁湛蓝，我们相信到现在都还是不退流行，它也是可以跟暖木棕做个结合。
Right, and in children's bedrooms, we also see this color palette being used in a beautiful way. It doesn't necessarily mean that if you're a child, you want to have bright colors around you. They can be also very sophisticated and, just nice.
那这张照片的话是儿童的卧房，大家可能讲到儿童房会觉得 ADE 通常用很明亮、很亮色系的，但其实不然哦。就是这张照片告诉我们，其实你也可以用比较沉稳的色调。
Right.So, I'm now presenting you the color palette of the hardwood home. And as you can see, and as I already explained, we are still quite fond of our blue. So denim drift of this year is definitely not out. And later onwards, I will show you a lot of other blue color palettes. So our hardwood home color palette is a beautiful flow from the blues,this year's color of the year, to hardwood, pinkish, more purplish tones, the color palette of next year.
好，那这个可以看到这一张就是我们今年设计出来暖木棕延伸出来的色组。那从最左边可以看到，我刚刚讲就是蓝色是还没有褪去它的流行哦，所以左边的话是蓝色调的，那它就是呈现一个很顺遂的流动。我们看到中间就是暖木棕，然后开始往右移动的话是接近比较粉色系的感觉。
Because Diane, this is something you definitely all know.Trends don't just start on the 1st of January and end on the 31st of December. Trends are more long-term, and if people committed themselves to denim drift this year, we're certainly not going to tell them to change their walls. or at least older wolves in on the 1st of January, they can just play around and highlight some colors in their houses, hold on to the colors they love, and then add, for example, our hardwood on some other walls.
那我們知道這個一個年度是從1月到12月其實是不斷的時間，所以就是如果有些人已經把它的這個設計定位是比較像去年流行的這個丹寧藍的話，那也不用擔心，其實你不用馬上把它轉換過來這個暖木棕，你可以慢慢的調整，可以先開始慢慢加入一些暖木棕的元素，所以我們這個色組的話，它其實是一個比較循序漸進的概念，不是說一下要你從這個顏色跳到那個顏色去。
Well, as I already indicated, home means different things to different people. So we are, well, we nominated those three ways of reacting towards the situation we live in at the moment, the unpredictability. And that's why we decided to go in depth and look at what kind of people these consumers are.
那就像我刚刚讲的，就是每个人对于家的定义不一样，就像每一个人对于这个动荡不安年代会采取的因应态度也是不一样的。所以接下来我就要谈到比较细节，就是以这样子的一个色彩心理出发的话，那每一个人家里的话可以用怎么样的一个应用的方式。
So I'm going in depth. I'm going to explain later. These are the three consumer types we nominated to be the people we want to explore and focus on, and that we want to create color palettes for that makes them feel welcome in the homes and the spaces they live, work, and relax in.
所以就是我们就将我们的消费者大约分成这三种人格特质的消费者，那针对不同个性的消费者呢，我们就设计出这三种不同的风格，让他们可以根据自己的人格特质，然后选择他们适合的风格来进行这个居家空间的点妆。
So I'm going to tell you something about the warm-hearted consumer.
那第一个类型呢，我把它称之为暖心仁厚的这个人格特质哦。I'm
going to tell you something about our open-hearted consumer.
那我也会第二型的话是把它定做比较知心开朗，就是比较 open-minded、比较开朗、开放型的这个消费者。And
I'm going to tell you something about our light-hearted consumer.
那第三种呢，我会把它称之为比较随性洒脱的人，他们就是生活喜欢充满趣味的。
So, but first, I would like to show you the color palettes that we designed for those three consumer types, and of course, repeat the color, the hardwood color palette.
那所以在这张图里面，我们可以看到，就是左边的话是暖心木的最基本的这个色组，那但是右边三组的话呢，就是因应不同的人格特质，我们稍微有一些调整，但是还是以暖木心为出发点，那因应不同人格特质的稍微有些不一样的色组。
And as you can see, these color palettes are relatively easy. There are 37 colors. We repeat the color of the year in all of those color palettes, so you will see it coming back. And the interesting thing is, I think, from a color perspective, that since I shared with you, the color of the year is so versatile and flexible, it changes in the context of those color palettes. So. The hardwood color palette, then it's really it's beautiful flow and it's part of this color palette. Whereas in the other color palettes, our color of the year suddenly becomes more pink, more lilac-y, and it really changes color. Very interesting, and I'll show you later how it works.
那就像我刚刚讲的，就是我们每年这个色组的话是由37个颜色组成的，它是相当弹性的，那它是用一个非常流动的感觉去呈现，所以你会发现，有的色组好像比较粉色系一点，那有的色的话就还是维持住就是棕色的基调，那但是这些都可以算是暖心木为出发点，它就是一个很弹性、很流动的感觉。
And we make color picking easy. Choosing color, the world outside is difficult enough. We have to make a lot of choices. And why not make choosing color easy? That this is something you don't have to worry about.
那在呈现色组的时候，我们尽量用一种简单好懂，然后也很好挑选的方式呈现给我们的消费者。因为外头的世界已经够纷扰了，很困难，我们不想把事情复杂化，所以这个色组的呈现方式是比较简单明了。等一下，我会用例子跟大家说明。
So, I'm going to explain to you about these persona and how what their interests are and how they, well, we think, who they are.
好，那接下来我就是针对这三种人格特质做一个更详细的说明，就是他们怎么样人格特质，然后他们是怎么样的人。
Yeah, so the warm-hearted person. This person is the consumer or the customer that is protective about their old way of living. They're very proud of their houses. They buy quality. They like to invite family and friends, but in a very considered way. They want to know in advance if somebody's coming for dinner, and then they prepare this lovely meal and they make their houses as beautiful as possible to make sure that everyone feels invited.
第一个类型这种暖心人后型的消费者呢，他们是比较重视他们原来的传统生活方式，他们以他们的家为荣，然后呢，他们其实也是乐意邀客人来家做客，但是他们会比较喜欢客人事先跟他们说，让他们有足够的时间可以准备，因为他们很重视品质，所以比如说邀客人来前，他们就会把家里布置得漂漂亮亮，然后准备一个精心的晚餐，所以他们是这样子性格的消费者。
So their home is really their castle. They're quality-driven, conscientious, thoughtful and grounded. And as said, they buy quality and they love to have quality around them.
那这种消费者，然后会把他的家视为他的堡垒。他是比较一丝不苟性格的人，所以他很重视品质哦。
So if you remember this graph I showed you previously, you can see that all these consumer types of course have the same things that are important in their lives, but for the different consumer types, some things are more important than other things. And in this case, you can see these people are really, what's really important in their lives is interior and shelter, whereas nature is, it's nice, but it's not as important, tech is you need tech, you need technique to be able to, well, work your way around to, well, this day and age. And not important, so that they invest a lot of time and money in it. And work is really important. These guys have steady jobs.
那所以这种，刚才记得我们有看到这个图，那就是它就是说明了，就是每个人心中重要事情的排序方式的比例不一样。所以像对于暖心人后型的人，他们就很重视他们的工作，然后很重视他们的内部居家空间，然后也很注重家给人庇护的感觉。但是相较之下，他们就比较不重视大自然或是科技，一定要很特别的科技才有办法抓住他们的心。
So this warm-hearted persona needs a comforting home.
所以这个暖心人后型呢，我们把它定位，我们要提供给他一个很舒适宜人的、舒适惬意的家。
Good. And of course, we base ourselves on what we see happening in design and in the art world as well. And this is an example of the Architectural Biennale in Venice. And their overriding theme was shelter last year.
那这个我刚刚讲过了，就是我们在讨论的时候会把这个概念应用在不止居家空间。像这张照片的话，是一个在威尼斯的建筑，它就是给人一个比较受到保护、受到庇应的感觉。
So, and we all know, we all feel that shelter is really important at the moment. So this is an example of what shelter could look like if you look at this warm-hearted person that needs a comforting home.
所以这个如果是暖心人后的消费者，他们就会期望他们的家有提供这个安全感，就是他们进到这个空间就有被保护、被庇应的感觉。
And this is what architecture could look like: closed on the outside, but really warm, nice, and comforting, welcoming on the inside.
所以这就是一个比较典型的，就是这种消费者会中意的建筑，就是他们跟外界是比较隔绝开来的。可是你进到这个建筑物内部以后，你会觉得很有安全感，会觉得这个建筑物内部是给你一种很放心的感觉。
And as I said, nature is really important, but then nature in a gated area. So nature that isn't wild or, well, say natural, but it's very, manicured.
那我们刚刚讲到，就是在大自然在这一类消费者心中，也许地位不是那么重要，就是他们也会喜欢大自然给你这种很空间的感觉，但是他们会希望大自然在他们的环境是呈现一种比较有修饰过的方式呈现。
The These people just don't like surprises. They don't want the fact that well, nature can surprise you. They want to have it under control. So this person, we said, this is the person that we create a comforting home palette for.
所以我刚刚说，就是他们心中。 大自然就不应该是那种很狂野的方式呈现，就是会以一种控制得宜的方式呈现。那他们的家就是会呈现这种比较整齐、一丝不苟的感觉。So
in this house or in this space, it can be your retreat to shut out the noise, your haven to shelter in, and your sanctuary to find balance.
那对于这类型消费者的话，他们的舒适惬意的家呢，就是让他们。 暂时逃离外界一切纷扰的地方，他们可以获得安全感的天堂，然后甚至是他们可以重新找回平衡的一个庇护所。
So what does this palette look like, and how do we apply it on the walls?
那这个就是我们的色组如何真正应用呈现在他们的居家的墙壁上面的感觉。
We decided that this persona really wants to paint, take care of their house in a very, very intense way. They love to paint the walls in a beautiful way, taking care of detail, beautiful little stripes. They use beautiful fabrics, nice materials, really something that, well, embraces you.
那像这类消费者，他们就是很注重细节，所以他们会用比较细腻的风格来装点他们的家。那你可以看到有一些织品类的装饰品呈现在他们的居家空间里头。
And as I said, we expect these people to work, to live in an environment that is under control. So a gated community, for example, or somewhere in a building that has a concierge and, well, keeps other people out that are not invited.
那我刚刚讲过，这些消费者喜欢生活不要那么多惊喜，喜欢他们生活是比较有规矩可循的。所以，比如说，如果是在一个社区的话，他们就会期待会有一个单位专门是来管理，就是不要让外界的闲杂人跑进来的单位。But
of course, they do love beautiful houses, so everything's taken care of.
所以他们希望他们家里每一件事情都是有人好好的把它照料好，打点好的。
Right, so warm woods, leather, silk, and velvet combine to create a space that you want to touch and sink into.
那在这类消费者的家中，你会看到这些材质，就是一些比较暖色系的木头、一些皮革或是一些丝绒类的材质组合起来，那就可以创造出一个你可以想要去触摸、想要去放松整个人陷下去的这种感觉。
So beautiful velvets, leather, polished woods, those are the products even in a bathroom environment.
所以像这张照片，我们就可以看到这些不同的元素，有一些丝绒啊，有一些皮革啊，还有一些比较打磨过、抛光过的一些木头。
It's really quality we're looking at. And as you can see, we combine this beautiful warm color palette on the wall in such a way that it really gives a beautiful backdrop for all those interior decorating products.
所以这是一个很有质感的家哦，就是在这个图片里面，我们可以看到这个墙壁的色调是走比较暖色系，然后提供一个很好的居家空间的背景。
Beautiful metallics as well. So copper, gold, and those kinds of materials we see being used a lot.
所以我们就会看到在这样的居家空间会使用到这些材质。
And just last but not least, here as well, we really believe that beautiful children's bedrooms are important to teach them what color is about and to kind of educate them as well-informed consumers, color consumers.
像这张照片的话是小孩房，可以怎么样应用这样子的一个风格？就是我们会试着要在小孩房里面教导小朋友对于色彩的概念。So
this is an example of office spaces, interior and exterior when it comes to this color palette.
那工作场合要怎么样用这种风格呢？我们在照片中可以看到，办公室的外墙还有办公室的内部都可以用这种风格。
So and when you enter this building, you will find this reception area to be a welcoming space.
像你走进这种风格的建筑物的话，你首先映入眼帘的就是这个欢迎你的接待处。
So, as I already explained and I showed, The color palette goes from beautiful ochre colors via the color of the year hardwood towards a beautiful dark burgundy.
所以像这种消费这种人格特质的消费者，他们的色组就是这样子组成的。最左边我们还是看到暖木棕为基底，然后往右边移动就会慢慢转成就是勃艮第红，就是比较红酒的这种粉红色系的颜色。
So remember our open-hearted consumer.
那大家还记得第二种人格特质吗？是比较知心开朗型的人格特质。
Inclusive, optimistic, collaborative, and containing.
他们的人格特质是很乐观，很乐于与他人合作，然后海纳百川。
And here as well, we share the same elements. Whereas in this case, in this consumer's case, all those elements like shelter and a job and technique, etc., are all equally important. These people have families, they have a job. But they're very busy. They just actually, it's fine. They're not interested in one specific thing. They're quite living their lives and trying to make their lives as nice as possible. Inviting family and friends over. It can be very spontaneous. We have you just sit on the couch, do some games, or have nice dinners. Where everyone's invited.
那这种型人格的消费者呢，他是比较均衡的一个人哦，那就是任何层面都是很均衡的，不会特别偏重哪一个。他们同样重视家人、工作，他们虽然很忙，可是他们也很乐于邀朋友来家里玩，那不一定要事先安排，可以比较随性就约来一起玩个游戏啊，吃个饭都好。
So, what does the shelter of this persona look like? This is an example of an open space. It is embracing, it is protecting, but there's definitely, the outside comes inside.
那这种人格的人的他们的空间会长怎么样子呢？可以看照片看到，他们就是室外和室内空间界限不明显哦，他们同时是开放的，但是同时又有一种提供安全感的感觉，所以是室外室内空间是整个很融合在一起。
So, an open shelter, flexible, transparent, but still nice and comfortable.
所以虽然有透明感，但是它又还是可以有舒适的感觉，有被保护的感觉。
And this is an example of Dutch architecture, it's quite close to where I live. And you can see that these houses that are being built at the moment give people the opportunity to grow their own food, to do it together, and to live in the nature that they are, they're able to feed their children in a healthy way.
这个照片的话是荷兰目前正在盖的一个建案哦。那在这个建筑物里面，大家可以在上面种自己想要种的东西，然后你就可以采收自己种的东西，然后提供健康自然的食物给你的小孩。
So we created the comforting home palette, the inviting home palette for this open-hearted persona.
所以我们对于这样的消费者提供的风格会是一种开放宜居的风格，很开放的感觉。
And as you can see, airy colors that invite family and friends in, take nature into your house, etc.
因为看到他们是很欢迎大家到他家做客，然后也融入大自然。
So this house can be your den to snuggle up in, your nest to grow and to develop in, and your camp to create memories together.
那这样子的家呢，我们可以在里面就是找一个放松的角落窝在那里，然后你可以在这个地方成长发展，那你也可以在这边累积你的记忆。
The inviting home. And how do we apply these colors to the walls?
那我们怎么样把这样子的色彩应用在他们的墙面上呢？
So.This is how you can apply these colors to the walls. Together with the color of the year, which is on the bottom part of the wall,